Hey Aquarius, what's up? Welcome to your reading. This is for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Aquarius, for a few of you, if you guys were in a repetitive cycle, right? If there was someone here who was just too damn slow and not moving the connection forward here, or you probably could have just left because it was a situation that was just going in circles, okay? Just going round and round but getting nowhere. It's still the same. I'm just being honest. It's still the same, okay? I'm just letting you know. It's still the same. The person's slow. So, I mean, they weren't probably investing in the past. The only thing is that, yes, they're ready. They have a plan in mind. They know they want you. They want to invest in you. But they're just ready. They're just not moving forward yet, okay? That's what I'm saying. All right. This is for Aquarius. From now until the end of November 2021, what's going on for Aquarius and the person they are dealing with? We're going to divide it into two piles. I'm going to remove the top cards from both the decks and leave it on the side for the outcome. Let's see. All right. So Aquarius, I think for a lot of you, either you've cut someone out, okay? There was some very mean or nasty communication that happened between you both, and you had to cut someone out. Or you could just be, you're just being very cold, very very logical right now. You could be giving someone a very cold vibe right now. Or there's this cold vibe to yourself, okay? I do feel that you could be waiting for someone, okay, all this while. But now you've reached a point where you're giving up on someone. You're turning your back towards someone here. Someone who you probably felt was a cheater, a liar. You could have cut off an air sign, but I feel this is you. Who cut someone off here, someone who probably put you on hold. You could even be dealing in a long distance relationship, okay, where you just felt that emotions are not working anymore. You were very optimistic, all right, that things would work out. So it could be a long distance relationship here, but eventually you realize that, you know what, you need to expand your horizons. You're turning your back to the situation. You're not waiting any longer and you're choosing to move forward. I feel you're making a decision to move forward. You're taking a risk, making a bold move, and just being prepared to move away from this person here, okay? Because someone here doesn't deserve you is what I'm getting. I think all this while you were thinking very emotionally, but now you are standing up for yourself and you realize that you need to trust your logic and facts when it comes to this relationship. And clearly this person is not worth the wait is what you think, or you just feel it's just not going to work out here. I do feel overall here you are in a very happy state. So either you are married to this person here, A, or for a few of you I'm getting that you want this, whether it is with this person or not. I think your focus is marriage, a happily ever after, the ultimate wish fulfillment, okay? So I don't see you as being happy on your own or in that smug energy. I feel you want to be in a relationship. I feel you want to get married. I feel you want kids. But overall, I feel you could just be chilling, having some good time with your family, or this is just what you want, okay? Overall, you want to be in a very content place. You could be very confused, okay? You could be very confused about, there could be a lot of options for a lot of you, okay? Maybe you're very confused with the options, okay? Which one is the best one? Or right now, you could just be, you know, in that dreamy state where you probably have a lot of wishful thinking, you know, and you want it all, but you're still not making a choice. For a few of you, I'm getting that you could be wanting a reconciliation with the person that you're not with right now. You could still be dreaming about that person, still be wanting the same with this person here. But it's just like, you know, it's like you can't help it. You still had to cut them off. You still had to cut the communication here because you just felt it wasn't worth it. But some of you could still be wanting the same thing and still be wanting to work on this connection. You still want to put in the effort, but at the same time here, you realize that you are the one who's putting in the work. So other people's opinions or work could also be a problem between you both, okay? So I feel for a few of you, you're still wanting to work on this connection. You still want a new beginning in love. You want to revive the connection. You want a renewal in love with this person out here, same person that you're not talking to or the same person that you cut off. For the rest of you, I feel you're cutting off someone for good. Okay, I feel that you still want a relationship, But probably a relationship where there is an equal give and take, where there is a relationship where this person is ready to meet you halfway and you probably are looking for new love. You're loving yourself, you're opening up yourself to other options, and you're choosing to welcome whatever the universe has for you. Okay, Aquarius, you're in a very self-love mode right now, okay, where you know what you deserve, and you know, you're literally opening your heart chakra now is what I'm getting. Either could be a new person that you're working on with, or this could be just you working on yourself and ready to put in the effort if someone is ready to match your energies is what I'm getting here. The person you're dealing with here is very, 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 very depressed, disappointed, upset. There's this lack feeling that they have here, and a lot of regret and remorse, a lot of would have, could have, should have that they have about this connection here, okay? Oh, I wish I could have done that. I wish I could have done this here. They know that they fucked up. They know that they sabotaged the connection. They know that there was a lot of manipulation and a lot of mind games that they played here. They know you walked away and now they're just standing there with that empty victory. Okay? And just looking back at the connection like, you know what? They know they're just beating themselves up for whatever they did. Okay? This connection here. I feel this person here is coming back towards you, okay? They want to come towards you, but along with coming towards you with an apology or wanting to meet you face to face, I feel this person here does want to invest into the connection and they want to take the next steps, okay? They want to invest into the connection and wanting to take the next steps in the relationship. So if you're friends, they want to date you. If you're dating, they want to make it exclusive. If you're exclusive, they want to commit. You know what I'm saying, right? But yeah, this person is practically wanting to invest into this connection. Could be a very small offer. Okay, let's catch up. Or probably they'll definitely invest into you. Okay, so this is a good investment here. But still, I feel they're very confident. They have made a choice about wanting to move towards you. But this person still has a choice. They're probably waiting and watching. Could be waiting and watching for you to reach out to them. Waiting and watching probably for the right time. But there's this wait and watch energy where, you know what? I want this with Aquarius. And now I want to take the next steps. So they're very confident about what they want with you or who they want. They want you. But I feel this person here could just be at a crossroads, trying to make or choose the right path. Now, I don't feel this person has to choose between two people here because clearly they want to invest into you. This person could be waiting to choose about which is the right approach to make towards you and which is the right time. Okay, so there's a lot of planning going on in their head here. A lot of planning here. But yeah, they want to reach out to you for sure. I do feel that this person here, in the past, if there was some kind of codependency, when I say codependency, it can be codependency about a third person here who they feel bonded to, they feel restricted to, or codependency could be fear, it could be commitment issues, it could be someone who is commitment phobic, it could be someone here who probably loves their independence, or it would just be someone here who is very codependent on their negative thoughts. Okay, repeating a negative pattern, could be addictions, could be some vices, could be some obsessions that they had. They are obsessed with you. They do feel restricted to this connection. They feel a strong tie, a strong connection, and they know they can't shake it off. But there is this person here who is changing. There is something that is shifting in this person here, okay? So I feel this is something that was destined and fated to happen. I feel this person here was not ready to learn their lessons all this while. They were probably repeating the same negative patterns over and over again. Now this person here is, the shift is happening, okay? And the shift is not because of this person. This person could probably be getting out of a sabotaging energy. They're getting into a more free energy, okay? Where they're getting into freedom, they're detaching from something that was stopping them from coming towards you, okay? And they're ready to make a decision, ready to make a choice, okay? And that shift is kind of very, very positive, okay? Because from the devil, we're moving to the wheel of fortune. So there is something that is shifting. There's something which is pulling them out of that negative zone, pulling them out of that self-sabotaging energy, and pushing them towards you, okay? This is the universe doing that. They haven't done anything. The universe is... luck is in their favor now, okay? So which eventually is in your favor here, okay? But I do feel like it's almost like, you know, the moment you give up is when they come in. But yeah, this person does look like they do want a reconciliation because they know that things have ended badly between you both, okay? They probably even are at a point where they realize that they probably disappointed you emotionally, so they know there's an emotional loss here, but they know they disappointed you because even though you trusted them so much, they couldn't live up to your expectations here. Okay, so they're still crying over spilled milk, but probably at the right time, they will come towards you and approach you. Let's see the outcome. What did I say? They are approaching you end of November. There is going to be an apology. There is going to be some emotional communication. It's going to be very initial. It's going to be very small. So don't expect some big displays of emotions here. This person here could be someone very scared to get vulnerable. Okay, so they're approaching you. They're coming back towards you. They're being very optimistic that things can work out between you both someday. But I think that this person here knows that you are the positive direction. You are the right choice. You are the one that they want. Okay, they've put you on a pedestal. That's awesome. They've put you on a pedestal, Aquarius. And they're coming back towards you with something emotional, some emotional communication here. I feel this is more of an apology here. So they will eventually make a choice to come towards you. They're going to let go of their fears is what I'm getting here. And there's going to be a shift. There's going to be a change in the way they think, in the way they feel here. And there is communication coming in and it's almost going to be like a wish come true for you. So Aquarius, don't expect something to come towards you the way you exactly wanted it. It may not be exactly the way you want it, but it's at least something close to what you wished for. Okay. So that's what I have for you. Hope this reading resonates. Leave your comments below. And I will see you next time. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.